Understanding total value to paid-in capital, TVPI, in venture capital. Venture capital, VC, is a high-risk, high-reward type of investment that involves injecting capital into startups and early-stage companies with the potential for exponential growth. To evaluate the performance of these investments, venture capitalists use several metrics, one of which is the total value to paid-in capital, TVPI, ratio. This video will delve into the concept of TVPI, its importance, how it's calculated, and real-world examples to illustrate its application. What is total value to paid-in capital, TVPI? TVPI is a private equity performance metric that compares the current value of remaining investments in a fund plus the value of all distributions to the total amount of capital paid into the fund by investors. It provides a snapshot of the total gross value created by a fund relative to the total capital invested. The formula for calculating TVPI is TVPI equals residual value plus distributions divided by paid-in capital. Residual value. This is the current value of the remaining investments in the fund. It's often based on the fund manager's assessment and may not reflect the actual market value until the investments are sold. Distributions. These are the returns that have been realized and distributed back to the investors. Paid-in capital. This is the total amount of capital that has been invested into the fund. Why is TVPI important? TVPI is a crucial metric for both fund managers and investors for several reasons. Performance measurement. TVPI allows investors to measure the performance of a fund by comparing the value of the fund's investments and distributions to the capital paid in. A TVPI ratio greater than 1 indicates that the fund has generated value, while a ratio less than 1 suggests a loss. Comparative analysis. Investors can use TVPI to compare the performance of different funds or different vintages within the same fund. This helps in making informed decisions about future investments. Risk assessment. While TVPI does not directly measure risk, it can provide insights into the risk-reward profile of a fund. A high TVPI may indicate a high-risk, high-reward strategy, while a low TVPI may suggest a more conservative approach. Examples of TVPI in action. Let's consider two hypothetical examples to illustrate how TVPI works. Example 1, suppose Fund A has a residual value of $500 million, has made distributions of $200 million, and the total paid-in capital is $400 million. The TVPI would be calculated as follows: TVPI equals $500 million plus $200 million, divided by $400 million equals 1.75. This means that for every dollar invested in the fund, $1.75 has been created in gross value. This is a strong performance, suggesting that the fund's investments have been successful. Example 2, now consider Fund B, which has a residual value of $200 million, has made distributions of $100 million, and the total paid-in capital is $400 million. The TVPI would be TVPI equals $200 million plus $100 million, divided by $400 million equals 0.75. In this case, for every dollar invested in the fund, only 75 cents has been created in gross value. This suggests that the fund's investments have not performed as well. Limitations of TVPI. While TVPI is a valuable tool for assessing a fund's performance, it has some limitations. Subjectivity. The residual value is often based on the fund manager's assessment, which can be subjective and may not reflect the actual market value. Timing. TVPI does not consider the timing of cash flows. Two funds with the same TVPI could have very different returns if one fund returned capital earlier than the other. Risk. TVPI does not directly measure risk. A fund with a high TVPI may have taken on significant risk to achieve those returns. Despite these limitations, TVPI remains a widely used and valuable metric in venture capital. It provides a snapshot of a fund's performance and can help investors make informed decisions about where to allocate their capital. However, like all metrics, it should be used in conjunction with other measures and not in isolation.